I spent the next 386 miles teaching myself how to fly a fucking spacecraft. I'm Rosebud Baker, and this is the story of how I drove my family 386 miles on mushrooms. In high school, I put in a lot of time, a lot of effort into becoming the absolute best pothead that I could be. Was I into glass-blown arts? Yes. Did I consider glass-blowing as a major in college? Yeah, I did. Was I into the band Phish? Yeah, I was. And that's an embarrassing fact. It's easier to admit that I'm a drug addict today than it is to admit that I was ever into the band Phish. I can't identify with that group of white gypsies. I mean, I would walk around these massive fields where white people with dreadlocks would be offering me battery acid to smoke. And I'm like, that's not a thing. And they were like, we could try it. Honestly, they might have created their own STD at this point. At one point, you know, you just get high over and over again until you're like, this isn't even doing anything anymore. That's how I got into mushrooms. It was really just to find out how much higher I could get. I thought it was a good idea to take my father to New Jersey to see Phish because he and my mother had like met at a Grateful Dead concert. I took my dad and my sister up to New Jersey for this Phish show. My dad was so in his element. We walked in and he just wandered off and left my sister and I to just kind of do whatever. And I was going through my purse, like trying to get something to eat. And I found this bag of mushrooms and I just bought this pizza. Pizza, mushrooms. I love a mushroom pizza. I ate the entire eighth. I didn't tell my sister and I definitely didn't tell my dad because he was like nowhere to be found. And the show starts. The lights are incredible. Everybody looks like a deck chair blowing in the wind. I'm having a good time. I start to feel it a little bit. I start to feel like warm in my stomach and like, you know, you get that like kind of fuzzy feeling in your cheeks. The things that amused you as a toddler start to amuse you again. An eighth, I'd never taken that much, by the way. I was like, if I pass out on my face, the man who's responsible for keeping me alive is here somewhere. I mean, he left, but he's around. In the middle of this, like as I started tripping, I remember Phish was selling these t-shirts with a totem pole that went all the way up to the neck, so that your head was like the top of the totem pole. My dad walked up with two of them and his head was on the top of this totem pole. I was like, what is happening? I screamed. I was like, the totem pole is talking to me. And my dad's mustache took on a life of its own. It was like moving. I couldn't stop watching his mustache move. My sister, honestly, she could have vaporized. I wouldn't have even noticed. At the show ends, I'm sure Phish played all of like three songs in 4 hours. We start walking to the parking lot. I look at my dad and he's like swaying like back and forth. And I was like, oh, I'm fucked up. And then I realized, no, 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 he's fucked up. We have to drive. And my dad turns to me. He does that like drunk turn where he's like, you know what I mean? Where the knees go first.
You wanna drive?
And I got a little paranoid because I was like, if I say no, he's gonna know that I'm tripping balls right now. And my sister was too young to drive, so I was the only option. Anybody watching this from the outside would be like, there is no option, you're staying in Jersey. I said, yeah, I got in the car, my dad got in the car. My dad was passed out, my sister was passed out. I spent the next 386 miles teaching myself how to fly a fucking spacecraft. It was honestly the most gorgeous drive of my life. It's the most scenic I've ever experienced. And I was like, sound isn't real, space isn't real, time isn't real. And I flipped the fuck out. I was scared the whole way. I do not recommend ever doing this. It's not safe. I was conscious in a way that I've never been before in my life. I remember there was a pickup truck in front of us. And there was a dresser on it. The bottom drawer of the dresser had slid out, so it looked like the dresser had an underbite, and it was like,
you're a bad person. You're putting your family in danger. You're never gonna breed.
I was having all kinds of realizations. Like, how irresponsible I was, but also, like, you know, what an interesting person. I can't, the fabric of reality was literally ripping apart in front of me. I don't know how, but we did arrive safely home. I truly believe in God because he got me from the Meadowlands to Northern Virginia with my family in the car. No one in my family knows that this happened. So if they're watching right now, I'm really sorry, but I did get you home safe. So I maybe deserve some credit for that.
Tales from the